No, people should not panic due to the somewhat unusual activity actively occurring at the Canary Islands' tallest volcano, Teide, on the island of Tenerife. While yes, this Spanish volcano is the most potentially dangerous volcano in the country, the signs of unrest it has been showing as of late are not only not new since they've been largely ongoing for years, just not really noticed by the public, but the current level of overall unrest is still quite low. But let's just for a second create a hypothetical scenario. Let's suppose that the Teide volcano was going to erupt exactly 3 months from now. What warning signs might we expect to see? Here's a quick list of 7 potential warning signs, the vast majority of which would likely be observed. With that in mind, how many of these 7 potential warning signs have been detected in recent months? Only one of these, well, technically half of 2 points have occurred. Specifically, an increase in the rate of volcanic earthquakes and the detection of very negligible ground deformation. Ever since November of last year began, the number of weekly volcanic earthquakes has jumped from an average of 18.13 to 32.92 a week. And the amount of this increase is somewhat misrepresented due to how strong Teide's mid-November 2024 swarm was. Seismic activity then decreased before rising once again starting in April, with a very slow long-term trend increase still ongoing at the present. And yet, for all intents and purposes, while abnormal, the current increase in volcanic earthquakes is still fairly minimal. After all, to me, what has occurred during the last 3 months just seems to be another negligible increase in overall volcanic unrest, which began all the way back nearly a decade ago in 2016. While this is still highly speculative, 2016 seemingly signaled when a new batch of magma began accumulating in both the uppermost mantle and lowermost crust beneath the Teide volcano. This magma intrusion has seemingly continued ever since at a low rate, only generating earthquake swarms when hydrothermal fluids and gas heated from the magma become pressurized at depth. In other words, my best guess is that if you were to currently view the interior of the Teide volcano along its northwest rift zone, it would currently look something like this. This statement is speculative once again, but the magma is likely quite mafic, aka low in silica, probably with a composition of trachy basalt, and is not located in Teide's northwest rift zone, which itself last produced an eruption in 1909. Instead, it is occurring within the large 15.5-kilometer or 9.6-mile-wide caldera of the volcano, meaning that in the highly unlikely event an eruption did end up occurring here due to the current unrest, lava would only flow towards completely unpopulated or sparsely populated regions. However, the vast majority of magma intrusions, assuming one is occurring, end up failing to reach the surface, with the deeper the intrusion is directly translating to a decreasing likelihood of eventually triggering an eruption. While slow buildups towards a volcanic eruption can occur, during my time observing and monitoring volcanoes, the opposite, a very rapid escalation in activity, such as what was observed in the 10 days preceding La Palma Island's Cumbre Vieja eruption in 2021, is far more concerning. And, of course, not even remotely similar intensity seismic activity has been detected on Tenerife Island, where earthquakes are still occurring at the same 8 to 12 kilometer depth range that they were 7 months ago. If relatively new magma is present and causing these quakes, whether directly or indirectly, the molten rock is probably located at the very bottom of these depth ranges. Despite not erupting since 1909, Teide is still a fairly active volcano with underlying bodies of magma still present, which have generated at least 125 earthquake swarms since monitoring began. And of course, none of these more than 100 events since its last eruption resulted in another new eruption, so there is no reason to suspect that the more recent earthquake swarms will be any different. As for the detected ground deformation, it has totaled a mere 1 centimeter or 0.4 inches since 2023 began. This is a very small figure, not really concerning, which is far less than the levels of yearly uplift these other volcanoes, which aren't also erupting at the present, are experiencing. So, in summary, traveling to the island of Tenerife or even onto the Teide volcano is still completely safe in my opinion. The level of volcanic unrest Teide is currently displaying is very weak, with zero signs that any form of volcanic eruption will occur here in the near future. Substantial changes would have to occur at the Teide volcano for me to change my analysis of this matter. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting my work.